Yes, paragraph number four. Reach for the top. A marriage as early as that was the last thing on her mind. She threatened her parents that she would never marry if she did not get a proper education. She left home and got herself enrolled in a school in Delhi. When her parents refused to pay for her education, she politely informed them of her plans to earn money by working part-time to pay her school fees. Her parents then agreed to pay for her education. So this is called willpower. This is the right form of protest. The protest is when you are fighting for justice for yourself. And then when you think like the things are not going in your stride, then you are ready to suffer. Okay, the parents, they wanted her to get married and she didn't. So in order to pursue her education, she went and took admission in Delhi. And there she, when it was a time of getting money for fee, parents refused. Because parents thought that if they will not give her money, then she will not be able to pursue her education and she'll come back. But no, she told her parents that she would earn and study. Right? Then parents had to give up because now they knew that now their girl, their daughter was independent enough to do what she wanted. Okay? So the kind of protest which this girl had undertaken, this fight was for her right to education. And education is for the betterment. Okay? So wishing always to study a bit more. And with her father slowly getting used to her urge for more education. So wishing always to study a bit more. And with her father slowly getting used to her urge for more education, Santosh passed the high school examination and went to Jaipur. She always wanted to study a little more, a little bit more. And her father also agreed always with her, okay, one more chance, one more. So this way she always got to do higher, better and better in education. And finally, after completing her high school, she went to Jaipur. She joined Maharani College and got a room in Kasturba Hostel. Santosh remembers, Kasturba Hostel faced the Aravali Hills. I used to watch villagers from my room going up the hill and suddenly vanishing after a while. One day I decided to check it out myself. What is check it out? To find out the reality or find out what the fact is. I found nobody except a few mountaineers. I asked if I could join them. To my pleasant surprise, they answered in the affirmative and motivated me to take to climbing. So from where did this girl, Santosh Yadav, get an inspiration to do climbing or mountaineering? Number one, the site of Aravali Hills, which she could view from her hostel window. From there, she could see the Aravali Hills. And then she could also see the mountaineering climbing up the hill or the villagers climbing up the hill. So in order to make out like who those people were, she got to know that those were the mountaineers. And by this time, she also wanted to do this. And she asked them if she could also climb. And she was permitted. Tell me, like, is every person permitted to go for climbing? No? Why no? Yes. So, what's the first step to go for mountaineering? Physical fitness. Right? You should be physically fit. Physically, mentally fit. Mentally also. Okay, if you are a little bit hitched, if you've got some mental problem, you cannot go and do it. Okay, so physical fitness is the first yardstick. Okay, if you are too obese, if there is something wrong with your body, biological system, then you won't be. Okay, so the other things are, somebody was right now saying there is a fear of mountaineering. So anyone who has a fear of mountaineering, will he go for... If somebody has got fear of height or of mountaineering, will he go there? He will not decide. He will not even make up his mind. Okay. So anyone who has overcome the fear, he only will ask for the permission. Okay. And do you think the fear stops us from doing something? Can fear affect our performance? No. Fear doesn't stop anyone's performance. It doesn't, you know, it doesn't make any obstacle in the way of performance. Because fear, whenever you are going, you have to go and give a speech on stage. Are you always very confident? The speakers always, you know, they are nervous before they go on stage. But yes, with experience, with preparation, with confidence, you are able to overcome your fear. Fear is, you know, fear is always there whenever you are going to do something great. Okay, fear becomes your power, provided you work for it, provided you have preparation done for this. When fear makes you work hard, you are channelizing fear. But when fear stops you from doing something altogether, that fear is stopping you. So fear should be one's power. Fear should not be one's weakness. Mind it. Is that clear? Whenever you say that I am afraid of this, I am afraid of speaking on stage. And because of that fear, when you don't even try to speak, you have made fear your handicap. But when you say, I am afraid of speaking on stage, but I won't and I will, then because of the fear, you'll work harder and you'll be able to do better. Maybe not in first attempt, maybe in second, maybe in third, but finally you will be. Okay? Success doesn't come in one go always. Sometimes you have to try for 200 times, then afterwards the success might come. Okay? So the fruit of success or the fruit of hard work is always success, but that success might come after a long time. Okay? If you see some people successful today with you, maybe those people might have been working hard for the last 13 years. Aur aapne shayad mehnat hi nahi kabhi ki. Getting, if somebody in your class is able to do something very easily, maybe that person had been putting in the best efforts for the last 15 years. And you might not have ever put. So aaj se start kar do. Maybe after 13 years, you will also be perfect. You will be at the same level where that person is today after 10 years, maybe after 5 years, maybe after 1 year. Getting? And it happens. For example, the Santosh Yadav. The mountaineers, those who have been going for mountaineering, when she saw them, were they ahead of her or not? You know, they were ahead of her. Santosh Yadav till now had never done this. But now when she will go for mountaineering, she did that. And she got ahead of the people, those who were already there. Are we reading the chapter about those mountaineers? Or are we reading about Santosh Yadav who started late? We are talking about Santosh Yadav. We know her. So you can start becoming perfect from any time of your life. It's never late, never. Late is when you don't start. Okay, some people start thinking ki maine aaj tak kiya hi nahi kabhi. It's okay, nahi kiya, but aaj se karo, abhi se karo. Okay, start doing. Start working hard. Hard work is, you know, read the thought written at the end of your assembly ground today. when you go home. Did you read that thought? What's written at the blackboard there? Note that display board. Anshar, did you read? From here you can't, but yes, when you go out in the full break, then you read that. And tomorrow tell me what was written there. Okay. Okay, so yes, now come back. Now you don't have to read. So then she got permission to go for climbing. There was no looking back for this determined young girl. She saved money and enrolled in a course at Uttarkashi's Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. You also know that she did not have any money of her own. All money was of her parents. The parents who were not even sending her to get education, do you think they will allow her to go for mountaineering? No, they will never allow. So will she be asking for money from them? But she started saving money to get admission in the Mountaineering Institute of Uttarkashi. So she got admission at Uttarkashi's Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. My college semester in Jaipur was to end in April, but it ended on the 19th of May. And I was supposed to be in Uttarkashi on the 21st. So I did not go back home. Instead, I headed straight for the training. I had to write a letter of apology to my father, without whose permission I had got myself enrolled at Uttarkashi. So Chaitanya will tell me in yes or no, did this girl take permission from her father? About what? My question was, did she take admission from her father to take admission in the college at Jaipur? Why did you say no earlier? Read question carefully, because I did not complete that. So read question 100% before answering in exams also. Sometimes we expect something and the question is different. Okay. So she had not taken permission from her father to take admission in Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. But now when she had to leave for Uttarkashi after the completion of her exams, she did not have the time to go to her house first and inform family. Because there was a gap of only, how many days?
Two days.
So in 2 days, she could not go her home and come back. She simply wrote a letter to her father telling him, let's see. Thereafter, Santosh went, I'm on page number 101, paragraph number 7 now. Okay. Thereafter, Santosh went on an expedition every year. Her climbing skills matured rapidly. Also, she developed a remarkable resistance to cold and the altitude. What is developing a resistance to something? Now we have those who got vaccinated, they have got to develop, they have developed resistance to? Yes. Anyone who gets vaccinated to some disease, it means that he has or she has got a resistance, power to fight with that disease. So she had also got the resistance developed to fight against cold or height. What is altitude? Height. Okay. So each year she went for mountaineering. Because of this, number one, her mountaineering skills became better. Secondly, she became immune to height and altitude. Getting? sorry, she became immune to height and cold, right? What does it mean she became immune to height and cold? Yes, now the sometimes if you are not immune to cold, what will happen? A little low temperature will make you sick. Temperature 24 se 16 par aate hi some children become very ill because they have low immunity to cold. Okay, Anji Mane, we explain what I'm saying. But why did this change come? Why did this change come? What makes you strong? Practice or exposure? Or Ansha, you tell. Yes. The question is like, what makes one strong or immune without vaccination? Okay. When we do something repeatedly, along with our physical fitness, maintaining your physical fitness is in your hands. Mind it. Yes. Sometimes you will not be able to adjust when you will not take care of yourself. Okay, we'll continue tomorrow.